For this demonstration, we'll add details in the mesh by adding patches to define a channel in the mesh generator coverage. To add a channel, we first need to create feature arcs along the channel banks. These can be created manually, generated using the Extract Features tool, or imported from other software. For this demonstration, we'll use feature arcs that were created previously using the Extract Features tool in SMS. We'll first duplicate the mesh generator simple coverage and rename this new coverage to Extents with Bank Lines. Next, we'll select the bank lines coverage and copy the arcs to the new coverage. To do this, select the bank arcs, then right-click and select Copy to Coverage. In this dialog, select the Extents with Bank Lines coverage. This adds the bank line arcs to the new coverage. We'll now turn off all the other coverages. We now need to clean up the arcs to create the channel polygon. To do this, we'll use the Clean tool to intersect the bank arcs. Next, we'll select and delete the resulting arcs which are outside the domain. We often want to create quadrilateral elements within the channel, so we'll work on that next. Let's turn off the image and the simple mesh to better see our new coverage. To begin, let's redistribute the vertices on the bank arcs. We'll select both arcs. Then we'll right-click and select Redistribute Vertices. We'll specify a spacing of 50 feet. This will set a constant vertex spacing for the bank lines. To create quadrilateral elements, we need to specify the patch mesh type. To demonstrate, let's create a smaller polygon by using the Create Arc tool and create an arc across the channel. Since we have added an arc, we need to build polygons again. Using the Select Polygon tool, double-click on the new polygon. Let's try changing the mesh type to patch and preview the mesh. Note how we have only one element at the upstream end of the polygon. Using the Select Arc tool in this dialog, let's select the upstream arc, then holding the Shift key, select the downstream arc. Under Arc Options, select Distribute. We'll enter 7 to distribute 7 vertices along each arc. Now we see that with the same number of vertices on opposite arcs, we get a nice uniform patch mesh. Now let's finish the rest of the channel. Let's change the mesh type to patch. Now select Preview Mesh. Note the error indicating patch polygons cannot have more than 4 arcs. Let's zoom into the upstream end of the polygon. Note that there is an extra node. To fix this, use the Select Node tool, select this node, and choose Merge under the Node Options. This preserves the node, but it will now be treated as a vertex on this polygon for meshing purposes. Let's frame the polygon. Now we select Patch again. When we preview, note that we still have an issue. When we have rectangular patches with high curvature, like the polygons for this channel, Creating patches can cause highly skewed elements. It can even result in overlapping element edges, which occurs in this case, producing the error we see here. We could fix this by breaking the channel into smaller rectangular polygons similar to the one we created earlier. The other option is to use source arc redistribution. This option is only available in the main window, so we'll exit this dialog. This option redistributes vertices along the one arc normal to the vertices on the other arc. To do this, let's first select the lower bank arc. We'll use this as the source arc. Note here in the status bar, this arc has an ID of 11. Now hold the Shift key and select the other arc. We'll right-click, select Redistribute Vertices, and then select the Source Arc option. Note that 11 is given as the ID of the source arc. If 11 is the target arc, we would need to switch these two. Click OK. Note that the vertices on the upper bank have been redistributed to be normal to the vertices on the lower bank. We can now select the polygon again and switch to a patch mesh type. Let's zoom in on the upstream end and change the vertices to add more elements across the channel on this end. Clicking Preview Mesh, we now have a nice patch mesh with uniform, well-shaped quads. We are now ready to create the mesh with the channel details by selecting Map to 2D Mesh again. This mesh includes the details of the channel. This concludes the demonstration for using patches to add channel details to a mesh in SMS. The exercise to follow will give you additional practice using these tools.